If you are a beginner, your animation probably looks something like that. In today's video, I'll show you how using just two basic techniques, your animation will start moving smoother and with a motion blur. Fast tips today, so without further ado, let's get into the Premiere Pro. So here is our 30 frames per second, 5 seconds long sequence with just a car image. And to create a basic animation, it would be enough to just go to the Effect Controls tab and use the Motion function by dragging the position toggle and putting the starting, ending and other keyframes on the timeline, depending on how and where we want our car to be moving. But to have additional control over the dynamics and motion blur, we will use a different effect. So let's reset our motion changes and move to the Effects tab. Here we'll look for the effect called Transform, drag it onto your image on the timeline, and then go to the Effect Controls tab. Similarly to what we did before, go to the position toggle of your effect and drag the image to where we want it to start. I don't want to start motion right away, so I will move forward the starting point to 1/3 of a second and click the stopwatch to add the keyframe. Then let's move our playhead to the middle of the timeline. Drag the car using the position toggle to the end of the screen, and you'll notice that the keyframe will be added automatically. Let's make a short pause in motion, adding an additional keyframe with exact same values a couple of milliseconds after. So now we have 3 keyframes. Let's go to the end of our timeline using the Go to Out button and move our car all the way back to the starting point. To finish our motion exactly the same place where we started, I will manually match the value from the position of our last keyframe with the value from the first keyframe, which is -603. Let's now add dynamics. To make our car accelerate and brake smoothly, we'll use this trick. Right-click the first keyframe, temporal interpolation, ease out. When the car brakes, we'll use ease in. Then again, ease out, and last keyframe, ease in. Now the motion looks much better, but we want to add some motion blur to it. Let's go to the shutter angle option and choose the value from 0 to 360. The bigger the value is, the more blur effect you'll get. I don't need so much blur, so I will input 180. Now our car is moving much more naturally and pleasing to our eyes. If you liked this tutorial, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos like that. Love you guys, and see you in the next one. Cheers!